curtain rises, float balls, trip levers, overflow tubes, ballpark supply valves, life-size inflatable pelvises, tank balls, valve seat shafts, filler tubes, and plungers are suspended in mid-air above stage. Walls and floors are made of porcelain. Ankle-deep worm, snake, and rat-ridden cesspools stagnate on proscenium floor.
Presently, I shall attempt to enucleate in stochastic terms how the time-honored métier of the composter in Schmoesiotzi has come to be superannuated in virtue of the immedicable odium aestheticum we now front. Traditionally, disturbatory and luniversity-trained dock makers were steeped in Western classical repertoire, the tacit inference being drawn that they were reckoned upon by their inculcators to know whenceforth they stood in relationship to the towering and formidable masturbators of antiquity. Ineluctably, once the smilistic and bogestural archetypes of sundry hysterical episodes were tautly entrenched in the collective unconscious, a composter of inlet could find he had little elbow room left in which to abreact his vultures through the instrumentality of chicken scrabs on lines, and would thus feel impelled to proceed fromwards chronologically in his quest for novitious and left-minded solutions. Such an impulse toward haseity of fartistic expression is what eventually gave rise to the clodderous relaxation of the splatter half of the 20th century. In his exordium to postmodernism, philosophy and the arts, a compilation of essays he redacted by various scribes, Hugh J. Silverman afforces to endain upon his dippers a broad, albeit forcible, éclaircissement of modernism. Quote, to be modern is to break with tradition, to interrupt the endless reiteration of classical themes, topics, and myths, to become self-consciously new, to attend to the modes of the times, to offer a critique of the conditions of one's own culture and society, to represent reality not as it is objectively and devoid of evaluation, but rather as it is experienced subjectively and with the transcendental or critical consciousness available especially to the artist. To be modern is to break with the past and search for new self-conscious expressive forms. In contradistinction to the dull dissats of clodderness dogma or the perennial wet blanket on a bouldering somber vest in the boondock syndrome, which is flagrantly evidenced in the adenoidal bean sets appertaining to fartistic foibles of the bygone jubilee, the plastic explosive arts have splayed a multiplicitude of twitsy pretzel measures that symbol junk-in-the-box departures from long-established precedents. The displosion of the TWA jetliner over Lockerbie during the hypo-Christmas season of 1988 is a basket case in point, having had a percussive effect whose reverberations were suffered across both hemispheres of our terrestrial ball. Other end samples, needful of Aydin's rotation, are the Tiananmen Square Oxygen of 89, the Gulf Feud Smattlings of 91, the Pyongyang Uprising of 92, the Waco of Waco debacle, and World Trade Center Explosion of 93. Tokyo Metro Sarinade, Atlanta Gymkhana Crumpings of 96. The spectabundle bisetters who dwell in gated communities of spiked guardrails, reinforced concrete, and high-definition television screens, eager beaverly abide ooze-making disastrophes to explete their apocalyptic yearnings and this wise aggregate their lethargine annoyances thereby. Contrary to what the crass media tell us, death toll hotlines with 900 numbers are one of the fastest growing oddities on the New York Laughingstock Exchange. In retrospection, this auth is unbeware of any binges in the stove wood, as it were, that would induce him to forethink, much less bemoan, his thick and thin involvement with music of the past. He never felt any common obligation to abide by the doughty indictments of the Wackademy or the slumberish oppressions of the outside veldt. Forby, 'tis patently conspectable that, void of mastering the building blocks of form, i.e. cantus, concordia, and degenerates into a rando mutt of Phillips, Robinson's, Quacks.
Thank you.
practice they ain't. Vanguards for wizards. Domains for brains. About modern Xerox. nobility that any stout-hearted warriors of vain and vacuous causes who despise pleasure, on being assoiled from their despective nut foundries, after having term upon term built walls of eggshell round richly bedecked boists and then loathsomely spanged from mountain pikes with plumbeous broilies in hand, wheeled at their dispatch against the slings and arrows of a hostile belt, by no means flailing to take under consideration, of course, that most chargers, including middle and bottom pieces of the high Renaissance through the Great War, or those at least which rely on our collective Andenken, have been test dropped belly first, eyes fearing blueward, into stifling gorges with dulcet canals, while monolithic stained glass minsters knell and gong, and common dumb-born birds flop and drop by among footmen and mudlarks in desperate suit of styrofoam popcorn and refrigerator magnets. Fists of bronze. Roxing unread atween tawdry tinhorn musaries can be applied to the modern cinematic genres as well, which is pressly, if not perjinkly, why such unquestioned classics as Doggone with the Wind, Morassa Blanca, and Pink Flamingos have endured the ravages of mold as well as the hideous despoilments of fangled and fashion. For mate moons, this larger volupted in the totally hyperactive or 100 modulations per minute arsenal, which was natively stockpiled in frosty little cubbyholes without key signatures in order to augment those goops and gobbins of the rich and
the poor. Excuse me, average investor who has followed along right now may be looking at what to do with their money, should they.
If that's not more abundant, and in harbor gross attention deficit maladies thereby from being exponent to the prey of theologizings and Euro-trashingly twisticated glimmifications of sidewalk futilitarians, street corner crate hangers, barroom drywalls, and other down-in-the-mouth mopes, the surly bow-wows and harumphs of which, at all hazards, are expressed devoid of any real formlessness. Real content being, in the words of Kierkegaard, miserably limited because of its intensity and self-absorption. These are ouvrages in which harmonic functionality heatens to the point of estuation, approaching the very stink of collapsion. That is, the instant at which it beslobbers its scalding broth over the margins into the non-tonal austere. N samples of which are Hugo Wolf's Intronezzo for Catgut Quartet.
Thank you.
Dislocations and fusions, assemblages and decompositions. A perfect revaluation of the past as it relates to the present becomes inescapable. The temptation to pull the rug out from under the tone system.
Pull the rug out?
The rug has been pulled out.
That's what I'm talking about.